One of the great ironies of my life was that I was born and raised on a farm where my dad, my uncle, and my grandfather used both braceros and undocumented workers back in the 50s. And when I was about 8 years old, during the summer times, my job was to be the lookout against the Border Patrol. I was very familiar with the work that the Border Patrol did. I can remember vaguely, but I can remember these big agents in their green uniforms with a gun reading me the riot act about they knew what I was up to. And I says, look, I'm just playing on the truck and blowing the horn. I said, oh, no, that's not what you're doing. People in elected office, they like to give you all kinds of statistics. Border Patrol agents, ICE agents like Peter and his people, see people. They handle people. This is a nation that was built on immigration. We have a legacy of being a nation built by immigrants. Well, let me tell you, I represent a border district. I represent a border community. We are impacted and affected by Secretary Chertoff's waiving of 36, 37 laws so that the federal government is not encumbered by these laws as they build this fence. The number of mayors that have taken a position against it and have become part of a group that's very outspoken about the federal government imposing this fence idea on our border communities. When the TV talks about a broken border, when it talks about a border in chaos, when it talks about a border that's out of control, it's not my border, it's not my district, and I know it isn't Salomon Ortiz's, Ciro Rodriguez's, Raul Grijalva, or any one of us from the border caucus that represent border communities. Do we have issues? Yes. But you know what? So does Dallas. So does Denver. So does St. Louis. But they don't get painted as being out of control. Never mind that the only documented cases of terrorists coming into this country have come through the Canadian border. There isn't any reason why the federal government ought to fund the sheriffs. They can help them, but they should not feel like they're getting federal funds to patrol the border. And by the way, those are real issues in Congress right now. There are some of my colleagues that are talking about, well, instead of helping Mexico as they fight the drug cartels, we ought to be funding the sheriff's offices so that they can go and patrol the border region. Some of you have asked me, how much is this fence proposal going to cost? Well, according to OMB, it's going to cost about $50 billion, and that's to construct it. To send this very negative message to Mexico and the rest of Latin America, we're creating our own version of the Iron Curtain. And if we use the 1986 law and the fact that back then, people thought we had from 6 to 9 million undocumented people under the initial amnesty program that was passed by President Reagan. Well, we only had about 3.5 million people that took advantage of the amnesty program and became legalized. One of the things that I have learned, and one of the things that you learn as whether you're a Border Patrol agent, an investigator, an inspector, is that you get blamed for decisions that policymakers make or don't make. You get blamed because the president of whatever administration decides that he's going to get tough on this issue or that issue. There are across the country, there are state legislatures that are entertaining, proposing, and have passed, as in the case of Arizona, very archaic laws where they mandate that local police enforce the federal immigration violations. Not the way we need to be going. I believe that the roles of federal agents to enforce immigration law is very different from your local police and local sheriff's department, regardless of 287G and all those other things that the previous Congress put into law. Because I think that that is ready-made for exploitation by criminals of an already vulnerable group of people living in our country. You can debate whether or not they're costing us money, whether or not they're paying taxes, whether or not they're stressing the whole overall system of the city, of the county, or the state. But they ought to be able, with a degree of confidence, to pick up that phone and say, somebody just broke into my house. Somebody just committed some kind of crime against my children or against my family, without fearing that that police officer that comes there is going to be asking them for their legal status. That's not who we are as a country. That's not who we are as a people. And that betrays our legacy of our country being founded as a nation of immigrants. Arizona has prided itself on passing tough laws against undocumented people, against immigrants. Passing tough laws so that they can send a clear message that if you don't have documentation, if you're not in this country legally, then Arizona is not the place to be. Well, I had a group of people from Arizona that wanted to know if I would support giving a federal waiver to the state so that they can do a guest worker program. Because guess what? They passed those laws, and now businesses are getting shut down because undocumented people are leaving the state. I think that there are three important components for us to take on the issue of immigration. The first one is border security. Everyone understands that we have to do a better job of securing the borders. All borders, southern border, northern border, and the borders along the coast. Second component is to make sure that we recognize that today in our country right now, there is a shadow world that if somebody wants to come in and take some kind of action against our country, they can move in this shadow world of 9 to 12 million people without any problem. And so what we need to do is make sure that we provide the means for those people living in this country that have a stake in our communities, that in most cases have citizen children or children that have been educated in our public schools and have paid taxes. So we've got to have a way to legalize those people. You have to have that component to draw those people out. And then the third point in comprehensive immigration reform is to provide a guest worker program. Whatever administration comes in and gets elected in November, I hope they prioritize immigration reform because it's vital, it's important, it's a matter of national security. Thank you for being here at this conference. Most of all, I hope that you in the field of journalism keep the pressure on at all levels because there is and there has to be accountability so that we prioritize comprehensive immigration reform, so that we prioritize giving the resources to those that we charge with carrying out our laws. And there are no magic solutions like having the police or the sheriffs or other law enforcement agencies take on that added responsibility, because it doesn't work. The answer is putting the pressure where it belongs. You know, I'm one of them. I'm speaking out that we ought to be doing this, but more people need to feel that heat. Only when they feel the heat will they see the light. Thank you very much.